thank God that the Holy Ghost has given us a witness that He's here. And since He can come to play, woo, He came to deliver. You wanted a move of God, so welcome to the move. Some of y'all don't understand. You ask for a move, and when a move comes, you just want to look at it. But you're in a move of God. I'll be reading 1 through 8 in your hearing. When you have it, can you just shout, I got it? The Bible reads, now after the death of Moses, the servant of the Lord, it came to pass that the Lord spake unto Joshua, the son of Nun, Moses' minister, saying, Moses, my servant, is dead. Now therefore arise, go over this Jordan, thou and this people, unto a land which I do give to them, even the children of Israel. Every place that the sole of your feet shall tread upon, that have I given unto you, as I said unto Moses, from the wilderness and this Lebanon, even unto the great river, the river Euphrates, all the land of the Hittites, and unto the great sea toward the sea, toward the going down of the sun, shall be your coast. There shall not any man be able to stand before thee all the days of thy life. As I was with Moses, so will I be with thee. I will not fail thee, nor forsake thee. Be strong and of good courage, for unto this people shall thou divide for an inheritance the land which I swear unto their fathers to give it to them. Only be thou strong and very courageous. Tell somebody, be courageous. That thou mayest observe to do according to all the law which Moses my servant commanded thee. Turn not from it to go to the right hand or to the left, that thou mayest prosper whithersoever thou goest. This book of the law, somebody say the book of the law, shall not depart out of thy mouth, but thou shalt meditate therein day and night, that thou mayest observe to do according to all that is written therein. For then thou shalt make thy way prosperous. For then thou shalt make thy way prosperous. And then thou shalt have good success. I want to speak from the subject, the mission is possible. The mission is possible. If I can just get a few remnants, we can land this plane. Oh yes, we can. Take your seats, I'm gonna work my text today. The book of Joshua details how Joshua is the successor of Moses. He led the people of Israel into the promised land of Canaan. It also records the military campaigns and the divisions of the land among the people. It is an indispensable bridge between the books of Moses and the history of Israel in the land of Canaan. Joshua is the climax of a progressive history as well as the commencement of a new experience for the children of Israel. The book of Joshua was written between 1400 and 1350 BC. Exodus is the story of God leading his people out of Egypt. So Joshua is the story of God leading his people to the promised land. His name was first Hosea, which means deliverer. But Moses changed his name to Joshua or Yahushua, meaning Jehovah saved. Moses knew that Joshua will be used to save God's people. Joshua finds himself in the capacity of leadership because of the loss of his leader. Now there are some significant things that I must pull out before we fly this jet. It is in Deuteronomy 34 that you will find something significant that takes place. Before Moses had died, the text reveals to us that Joshua was not left unprepared for the mission. In verse 9 of Deuteronomy 34, we see that Joshua, the text says that Joshua is full of wisdom. He's full of wisdom because it shows that Moses laid his hands and imparted into Joshua. If you are going to do the mission that God has given you, do it with a hand laid on you. God, help me in this house. In other words, even though Joshua had been released to do something great, he needed his leader's hand on him. God. He had to have the leader's hand on him, otherwise he could possibly forfeit the promise. So with this vital information, we can all agree that the mission that Joshua is about to embark on is possible. Now, as we look into our text, the very first chapter starts out with an announcement that an old regime has died. It shares with us that after Moses died, God speaks to Joshua. Can I share a nugget with you this morning? Sometimes God won't speak until what was once assigned to you becomes no use to you and dies. Oh, my God, help me in here. I'm going to preach anyway. God don't speak, watch this now, to a new leadership while the old headship is still in position. Help me in this house. Joshua only heard the Lord speak his new assignment when God so honorably laid to rest his mouthpiece, his prophet, his servant, Moses. The Lord speaks to Joshua and tells him, "My servant Moses is dead." In other words, what God was saying is, what I directly imparted into is dead, but now I'm ready to use his servant who he imparted me into. Oh, God, help me. I feel like preaching in this house. He says to Joshua, "Arise," meaning change your position. Help me in here. "And go over this Jordan and take this people with you," watch this, "unto a land which I give you." Notice this, that God doesn't give Joshua a long dialogue on the death of his leader. God approaches him with the mindset of, you have been trained, oh my God, to accept what I allow to happen and taught obedience to follow what I say. So get up. Okay, I'm losing y'all. I can see that right there. Oh God, I can't slow down. God tells him, "I'm going to give you this land. And every place the sole of your feet shall tread upon is yours." In other words, the mission is possible because I have set a path of victory for you. The only thing, Joshua, you must do is follow my instructions. Won't you just touch your neighbor and tell him, just follow the instructions. Many times the mission God gives us becomes impossible because we don't do it the way God said. We hear the instructions and begin to tweak the command to fit our belief and our mindset. But Galatians 5 and 9 says this to us on this morning. A little leaven will leaven the whole lot. Once you mix you with God, it's no longer pure. But once you keep God as God, you can do whatever it is that God tells you to do. Help me in this house. Sister Shannon, the mission is only possible when you follow the instructions of God. He tells Joshua, "It's yours because there is an inheritance that was not possessed by Abraham, Isaac, Jacob, or Moses. But now it's yours." Oh, let me in here. God begins to give him a survey. He begins to give him a survey of the land which was released to his possessions. He says, from the wilderness of the Lebanon, even to the great river Euphrates, all the land of the Hittites, unto the great sea toward the going down of the sun, shall be your coast. In other words, what God was telling Joshua, just look out at every direction that I'm telling you. As far as you can see, it's yours. As far as you can go, it's yours. Everywhere that I called out, listen, it's not optional to be yours, but it's guaranteed to be yours. Help me in this. The mission is set in place. The perimeters are established. The victory is guaranteed. This mission is possible. God tells Joshua, there shall not any man be able to stand against you. Not a man, not a foe, not an adversary, not an imp, not a witch, not a warlock, not a stronghold that shall be able to stop this mission. God goes on to give him reassurance, or what I like to call an all-access pass, that as I was with Moses, so shall I be with you. Now watch this. Moses spoke to burning bushes. He turned a rod into a snake that walked, swallowed up his enemy's snake. He had clouds that lead him for directions, and pillar clouds at night that hide him from endangerment. He caused the ground to open up and swallow those that opposed him. He commanded a body of water to gel up and allow him to walk on dry land. He prayed for sickness of death.